Washington, although it might as well be Mar-a-Lago, the President of the United States will deliver a speech to the American people. The President, in his State of the Union address, will follow the time-honored and constitutionally mandated tradition of giving a report on how we're doing as a nation. But he won't be speaking to all Americans. Instead, he'll only be talking to a portion of the country, a narrow sliver of the nation to whom he directs most of his rhetoric and attention. We, on the other hand, have gathered here in Skid Row to represent that share of the population whose needs and concerns are not being addressed. We're here to talk about the millions of Americans who are overlooked by this White House. Through words and action, the President has made it clear that he only cares about a certain group of people. The President's vision for this country is limited because he only sees some Americans. He doesn't see the hardworking people who don't make a living wage, who struggle with the humiliation and self-recrimination and shame because they can't support their families. He doesn't see the most vulnerable among us, homeless individuals who are mentally or physically disabled, huddled in doorways for a bit of warmth, sleeping on the sidewalks of our cities. He doesn't see the millions of Americans who can't pay the rent because there's just nothing affordable out there, while Washington advocates its responsibility to do something about it. He doesn't see the homeless children and the unaccompanied young people who are living on the streets and fending for themselves. He doesn't see returning citizens who have exited the prison system, desperately in need of a decent job, but relegated to shaking a cup for spare change. He doesn't see older people on fixed incomes, standing in line at the food pantry and slipping that much closer into a life of poverty when they ought to have the security of stable incomes in their retirement years. Mr. President, your remarks tonight ignore all of those people because you just don't understand. You haven't tried to understand. Your State of the Union is a flawed and false report that's based on inaccurate perceptions and incomplete assumptions. The number of homeless people in America is rising. That is the state of the nation. Corporations are making record profits, while too many of their employees have to depend on food stamps and public assistance. That, Mr. President, is the state of the union. This country has the highest child poverty rate in the industrialized world, while our social safety net is in tatters. That, Mr. President, is the state of our union, and as God is our witness, we will rise above this low point in our nation's history and demand a government that serves all of its people.